Hi guys, welcome to my class. Our topic for today is about order pairs. You're going to learn it here, the easy way. In case you are new to my channel, please subscribe so that you will be kept updated on the next math lesson. Then, like and share so that you can also help other students. We are going to learn today how to graph points on a coordinate plane to solve real-world and mathematical problems. Let us study first what is the meaning of coordinate plane. A coordinate plane is a two-dimensional plane formed with the intersection of the vertical line called the y-axis and the horizontal line called the x-axis. The intersection point of the two lines is called origin, while any point on the coordinate plane is called ordered pair. I want you to remember the horizontal line on the coordinate plane, that is called the x-axis. And the vertical line is the y-axis. Remember that? Ordered pair are two numbers that is enclosed with a parenthesis. And the first number is always the x-coordinate, while the second number is the y-coordinate. Let us work on this example so that you will be guided. Locate the point of the ordered pair for point P. We are going to start from the origin, which is 0, 0. I mark it with a red dot. That is the ordered pair, 0, 0. I want you to remember that whenever we are going to locate points or ordered pair, we are going to start from the origin. So from the origin, we will move 2 units to the right. Then, we will move up until we reach point P, which is 7 units up. So, point T is located at ordered pair 2, 7. Let us work on another example so that you can understand it well. Locate the point of the ordered pair for point R. Remember that we are going to always start with the origin, and I mark it with a red dot. To locate point R, we are going to move 4 units to the right. Afterwards, we will move up until we reach point R, which is 2 units up. Therefore, point R is located at the ordered pair 4, 2. Let us work on another example so that you can hit it off. Locate the point of the ordered pair for point U. Starting from the origin, which I mark with a red dot, we are going to move 5 units to the right. Then we will move up until we reach point U, which is 9 units up. Accordingly, point U is located at the ordered pair 5, 9. It is easy, right? Let us apply our lesson in the real life situation. Instead of using the GPS, we're going to use the coordinate plane to locate Iman's house, playground, and school. Starting from the origin, which I mark with a red dot, we will walk 4 units to the right and 1 unit up, and that is Iman's house. Now, let us locate the playground. Starting from the origin again, we will walk 1 unit right and 4 units up, and that is the location of the playground. Let us locate the school. Starting from the origin again, we will walk 6 units right and 7 units up. The ordered pair of Iman's house is 4 and 1. The playground is 1 and 4, while the ordered pair of the school is 6 and 7. It is easy, right? We can also apply the coordinate plane location of the ordered pair in the real life situation. Let us move back to the mathematical problems locating the points of each ordered pair. I want you to always remember that in the ordered pair, the first number is the x-coordinate and the second number is the y-coordinate. Subsequently, if the x-coordinate is positive, you are going to move right. But if the x-coordinate is negative, you are going to move left. Likewise, if the y-coordinate is positive, you are going to move up. But if the y-coordinate is negative, you are going to move down. Let us answer the first number. The x-coordinate is positive 3. So, starting from the origin, we are going to move 3 units to the right. Likewise, the y coordinate is positive 3, so we are going to move 3 units up. Therefore, the point of the ordered pair 3, 3 is point N. Let us work on the second number, which is negative 5 and 1. Since the x coordinate is negative 5, we are going to move 5 units to the left. The y coordinate is positive 1, so we are going to move 1 unit up. And we are going to reach the point A. The ordered pair of negative 5 and 1 is point A. Let us work on another example, which is number 3. And the ordered pair is negative 3 and negative 3. Since the x coordinate is negative 3, we are going to move 3 units to the left. However, the y coordinate is also negative 3, so we are going to move 3 units down. Correspondingly, we are going to reach point P. Therefore, the ordered pair negative 3 and negative 3 is point T. Let us work on the last number where the ordered pair is 4 and negative 5. Since the x coordinate is positive 4, we are going to move 4 units starting from the origin to the right. However, the y coordinate is negative 5, so we are going to move 5 units down. And we are going to reach letter H. The ordered pair 4 and negative 5 as a point of letter H. Our topic for today is very easy. And we have met our goal for today's lesson. We have learned how to graph points on a coordinate plane to solve real world and mathematical problems. To wrap it up, I want you to always remember that if you're going to locate the ordered pair in a coordinate plane, if the x coordinate is positive, you're going to move right. And if the y coordinate is positive, you're going to move up. However, if the x coordinate is negative, you're going to move left. If the y coordinate is positive, move up. Furthermore, if the x coordinate is negative, remember, move left. If the y coordinate is negative, move down. Yet, if the x-coordinate is positive, move right. And if the y-coordinate is negative, move down. Always remember that. To make everything clear and easy to remember, if we are referring to the x-coordinate inside the ordered pair, it is the first number. If it is positive, it is going to the right. However, if the x-coordinate is negative, it is going to the left. While the second number on the ordered pair is the y-coordinate. If it is positive, it is going up. Nevertheless, if it is negative, it is going down. It is easy, right? I want you to always remember that the first number in the ordered pair is the x-coordinate, and the second number is the y-coordinate. It will never change. Remember that. The x-coordinate first, then the y-coordinate. Okay? To conclude our lesson for today, I want you to always remember what His Highness Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, may his soul rest in peace, wrote for us. Education is like a lantern which lights your way in a dark alley. Sheikh Zayed wrote and left this quote for us so that the youth will always remember the importance of education. The genuine concern of Sheikh Zayed for his nation will always remain, as this quote will hand it down from generation to generation. And to encapsulate our lesson for today, I want you to always remember that life is a math equation. You cannot get the most of it if you cannot convert the negatives into positive. I do hope you have learned a lot for today's topic. And you find it easy, okay? Till next math lesson, bye-bye!